adult life to making this organization great. But in order to understand Diane's enormous contributions to our association, we need to look back to 1990, when she first took the reins of the organization. So, let me give you a 60-second history lesson for perspective, especially if you were in grade school back in the 90s. As you'll see from the pictures, that will start soon, if not already. Women in the 90s had really big hair. Most men had really goofy looking mustaches. That includes Diane with the big hair and yours truly with a goofy mustache. I've been in the apartment business for 40 years. This last decade has been the best run of good news for our industry in my lifetime. Rental business is booming, the economy is booming, Nashville is booming, but today's encouraging environment is nothing like the beginning of Diane's career 30 years ago. Multifamily housing in the 1980s was destroyed by the federal government. Might even be called the Great Depression of the rental industry. Here's how that happened. They created an incentive in 1981 to encourage investors to build and own rental properties across America, and capital flooded into apartments. Then in the middle of one night, in 1986, the federal government took those tax incentives away and stupidly did that retroactively. That destroyed apartment values, that drove management companies into bankruptcy, put hundreds of financial institutions out of business. Foreclosures were everywhere, vacancy was high, our industry was a mess, and it took years to overcome those foolish decisions of our Congress. Diane Carter became our association president in the beginning of that recovery, with many properties and management companies still struggling. I was chairman of our association in her first year, and we faced declining membership, weak participation in meetings, and $20,000 of unpaid bills that the association owed to local businesses. Our budget was only $100,000 compared to a $2 million budget next year. Diane was our only employee and was making just over minimum wage. Congratulations for that. Times were tough, and we couldn't even pay our national dues for a short time. We had to drop out of the National Association, quickly got back in. But by the end of that first year, Diane's first year, under Diane's careful management, we paid all of our old bills, had a surplus of $27,000. Our association has never been in financial trouble since that time. Because for the next 29 years, we had an exceptional, creative, hardworking, well-organized, never-complaining association president who made this association better and stronger every year. Diane's accomplishments are far too many to list, and I need to be efficient, as you know, with my time. Nashville has obviously grown from a second-tier city to a first-tier destination city, especially for bachelorette parties. I don't know how we got assigned that gig. Our apartment association has grown with it, but that is because we've had an excellent president in Diane, who leveraged that growth and gave our industry a strong voice in this city and state. We now have political influence, which protects us from terrible legislation like mandatory rent control and other hideous capital killers that have been attempted here in Tennessee. Diane has, through her careful leadership, enabled us to have a loud voice and to maximize our influence. Diane was recognized as the Executive Director of the Year nationally by the National Association just 3 years after she started, and and was a key player in hosting the National Association Conference here in Nashville in 95. Our membership and number of units represented has quadrupled under Diane's leadership. Our Nashville Association has won many awards and recognition for our membership growth. Our annual awards event barely had 200 members in attendance in 1990, but as you can see from the size of the room, that has increased by 800% and is now a major, not to be missed prom date with a convenient annual excuse to buy a new dress and more shoes. Our market statistics department didn't even exist when Diane started, but that has become the most important, unbiased voice for regional market conditions and apartment investment statistics. We've given back to our community and the nation because Diane has spearheaded disaster relief. Thank you. Old men, old voices. We have given back to our community because Diane has spearheaded disaster relief efforts like Operation Apartment Angel to assist Hurricane Katrina victims. And then 4 years later, with emergency aid for our own displaced victims of the 2010 Nashville flood. We've supported disabled children now for 25 years through King's Daughter Child Development Center. She has led our efforts to support in the support of the homeless and underprivileged through Nashville Rescue Mission, Nashville Parks Department. Our organization has now held an annual education conference for the last 10 years to support the growth of our members and to provide access to the best multifamily instructors in the country. Diane also gets the GNAA Bonus Attendance Award because, get this, in the 348 board meetings over the last 29 years, Diane has not missed a single one. That it's amazing health record. She has accomplished all of this for you, and she has had to, without complaining, adjust to 29 different bosses through her 29 years of service. It is my great honor to present on behalf of everyone in our industry the 2019 Lifetime Achievement Award to our beloved president, Diane Carter. Please stand.
I've received from my work here at GNAA. Winning this award would not have been possible without my God, my family, my amazing staff, the inspiration I have received from the leadership, board of directors, and all of you, the members of GNAA, over the past 29 years. Getting here was not easy. I was born and raised in Champaign, Illinois, the middle child of five children. So, but being what is known as the family peacekeeper and problem solver would prepare me for my career here at GNAA. In the fall of 1990, my decision was made to make a move to Nashville. My sister Denise made the connection for me with her manager and incoming association president, Faye Ellis. Faye needed to hire an administrative assistant for the association. It would be Faye Ellis who decided to offer me this lifetime opportunity. So now I could go to Nashville, I thought. Convincing my parents of 31 years at the time would not be so easy. My dad would tell me, "You just can't go." It would be my Aunt Mary who I would receive the final piece of advice that would encourage me to accept the position and make my way to Nashville. I began my journey here on a snowy, icy day in December 1990. My little white farmhouse of belongings packed neatly into a horse trailer and my two little boys in tow. We made it to the first exit out of town when we realized that the truck would not pull the trailer in such treacherous weather conditions. I was distraught as I agreed to start work in just a few days. Spent the day fretting over my situation. There were no moving trucks available on such short notice and in such bad weather, and I just really needed to get to Nashville, so I start work here at the Apartment Association. I had my whole family strategizing on what to do next. A semi-trailer truck at my Uncle Ted's farm is where we found our solution. My brother Dennis moved all of my belongings from horse trailer to semi-trailer truck in freezing rain. By nightfall, on an expired set of tags, which was unknown to us at the time, we were finally off to Nashville. My first weeks and months on the job were indeed rough times for the multifamily industry and the Apartment Association. As Jim discussed, membership growth and retention were both challenging. But by the end of 1992, under Jim's presidency, our membership had not only stabilized, but grown substantially. I knew that being promoted to the executive director in 1992 meant that it would become my passion to make this association the best in the country. As I mention your name, please stand to be recognized, and please remain standing. My beautiful mother, Grace. My husband, Henry. Henry assisted the association in gaining financial stability in the early 90s and stepped out of the line of succession to be president in 1993 so he could become my husband in 1994. He's been my greatest supporter every step of the way. My children, Ben and Chris, and their families. My sister and her husband, and my brother, and my cousin and her husband. Our GNAA amazing team of experts. This team works so hard for all of you and for me every day. Vice President Scott Merritt, Education and Events, Jenny Johnson. Finance, Connie Morris. Statistics Specialist, Bobby Turner. Membership Coordinator, Jenny McWhorter. Marketing and Design Specialist, Vicki Lynn Diaz. To the leadership from the National Apartment Association, and congratulations on the monumental news that NAA now represents over 10 million apartment homes globally. To all of our Tennessee Apartment Association leadership, please stand. To the 29 chairmen that I have had the privilege to work with, Harold Morris, established committees that led our board members that are led by our board members in a system that is still used today and play a vital role in the success of GNAA. Fail us for giving me this lifetime opportunity. Jim Gortmaker, the most inspirational person in my career. Jim spearheaded my promotion to association executive. We later led the efforts to charter the Tennessee Apartment Association in 1996. Troy Weaver, Troy served two terms as chairman. Thanks for sharing office space and expenses with GNAA when times were tough. Marty Heflin, who left the association effort to change our name and logo from Nashville Middle Tennessee Apartment Association to the Greater Nashville Apartment Association, and who absolutely made all of us look smarter. Joyce Wolf, for your sincere leadership in making sure I could eat a few chocolates along the way. Nancy Morris, she chaired our 1995 convention committee, spearheaded our amazing office renovation, and is truly one of my best buds. Andy Gass, your slogan was 57 in 97, 500 members in 1997. Linda Page, Linda also served two terms and served as our National Apartment Association Region 4 Vice President for 15 years. She has worked along beside me on this amazing event for over 20 years. Barbara Haynes, for your free spirit and love of all of our balloons. Susan Sherfield, for moving back to Nashville and continuing to lead this association in education. Kirby Davis, for all your support and being the association's budget and finance expert. Rita Wilkinson, for knowing when we had to be tough and get down to business and also knowing when it was time to have some fun. Ellen Parker, for presenting me with the Heart Award. Judy Rose, for setting the best examples of checks and balances. Mary Bradley, for establishing personal appearance policy and career apparel. Brad Cather, for your industry expertise in the areas of conventional and affordable housing, and just my go-to guy on every subject. Shari Lewis, for creating the memorable phrase, "Grow with Us." Linda Mason, who gave me this inspirational card at the end of her term that said this: "The person who says it cannot be done should not interrupt the person doing it." Berlina DeRouche, for all your volunteer leadership. Michelle Cathy, for encouraging us to each find our own way to success through GNAA involvement. Shelley James, for many years serving GNAA and TAA and implementing the Leadership Lyceum. Tammy Lee, I love all your zest, just for all your zest. Stacy Mullen, for your motivational leadership. Diana English, for the 100,000 units campaign, and we did it. Lisa Swick, for listening and understanding before making a decision. Andrew Klon, for serving as our 50th year chairman and solidifying the foundation that laid the past 50 years to build 50 more. Stephanie Burns, for the creation of the next gen, the future of GNAA. And to my dear friend, Wes Hall, who has served on the board for the entire 29 years I have been here. For never skipping a beat and instilling in me the importance of dotting your I's and crossing your T's with everything. GNAA current and past board members, please join in standing. All GNAA members who serve on a committee, please stand. And to all of our members who support the association every day, please stand. I want to sincerely thank each and every one of you. Everyone needs a mentor in life, and I am so lucky to have found mine in all of you. Thank you.